So today what we are going to start with, we are going to start with the Cassandra. Remember, like MongoDB? MongoDB was the document-oriented database. Everything was based on the documents, like collection was there, the document was there. Like collection is just like the table with the normal SQL. Like document was there, this is just like a normal record. So basically the Cassandra we can use for the unstructured data if we don't have the any predefined schema. If nothing is fixed there, I can go for the MongoDB. But in case certain thing is fixed, like we are having some structure, then what we have to do and what options we are having. What I want to do, I want to get the advantage of the NoSQL using tabular database. Tabular means what? Like Oracle, it's a tabular database. Like the data will get arranged into the table, the record will be there, the row and columns will be there, everything just like the SQL based databases. But at the same time, I want to get the advantage of the NoSQL also. So what is the advantage of the NoSQL? Like open source, free of cost, we don't need to purchase the license and all. So these are the advantage of the NoSQL. Again, 24/7 availability, easy hardware for the clustering and all. So what my purpose is, I want to take the advantage of columnar database using NoSQL. So MongoDB was the document oriented database, but what exactly the Cassandra is? It's a columnar database. Columnar database means what? Everything is based on the column. Like table will be there, within the table there will be the predefined schema. Like EMP table is there, there will be the employee number, there will be the employee name, there will be the salary. The predefined schema will be there. Under the employee number, like you need to put the values. This is just like your Oracle. But the good thing about it is that we are having the advantage of the NoSQL as well. So first of all, what we need to do, we need to install the Cassandra, and after that we need to work with the Cassandra. Like, so Cassandra is basically, it's a product by Apache. It's a product by Apache. Initially it was developed at Facebook. It was developed by Facebook. But later on, now it's a product of Apache. This is the registered company for the Cassandra. But initially Cassandra was developed by Facebook. The developer was Avinash Lakshman and Prashant Malik. Basically, they were the developer, they were the programmer at the Facebook, and they developed the database for Facebook basically. And for that purpose, and later on, that particular product get purchased by the Apache. So now, for the time being, right now, the Cassandra is the product by Apache, number one. Number two, what we need to do, we need to install the Cassandra. To install the Cassandra, what we need to do, number one, we required JDK with our system. Number two, we required Python with our system. And after that, we required the Cassandra over there. So to install the Cassandra, the first thing, we required the JDK. It's 1.8. Python, it's 2.7. Most suitable version is 2.7. And then we can install the Cassandra. So first of all, what I'm going to do, I'm just going to start with the Apache website. So I'm just going to write apache.cassandra.org. This is the home page we are having, like cassandra.apache.org. This is the best site, this is the first website, like this is the URL we need to start with. So this is the first thing. I'm just going to make it copy over here, so you will get the advantage of this. So this is the URL. Now the second thing, what we need to do before downloading the Cassandra, I'm just going to click on the documentation. In the documentation we are having getting started. The second step, we need to click on the documentation, and here we need to click on the getting started. Getting started. Under the getting started, we are having the prerequisite. We just need to click on this prerequisite. So you will get the clear picture like what exactly is required. Under the prerequisite, if I'm going to click on, under the prerequisite, the two things is there. See, the first one, we require the latest version of Java 8. And better, don't go for the JDK 14 or 6 or 7. Just always it will be better go for the Java 8, JDK 8. That will be the better option. So what I'm going to do, this is the first thing we required. The second thing we required, Python 2.7. The different versions is also available over there, but better go with the Python 2.7. Otherwise, it's create a lot of problems. That's why I'm writing specifically like you need to do this. So what I'm going to do, I'm just going to click on this Oracle Java Standard Edition 8. So this is the first thing I'm going to install, JDK 8. Now, we are having JDK 14 is there, 13, 11. I'm just going to select the 8. Yeah, it's JDK 8 is there. Now, I'm just going to click on this JDK download, and the download will get started. And we need to start the download for what? Like, we are using the Windows. So I'm just going to select the Windows, and my system is 64-bit. So I'm just going to start with Windows 64, and I'm just going to click on this JDK8U241-Windows64.exe. We just need to click on this. Yeah, the download will get started. I need to accept this. Click on this. The download will get started. It's already downloaded with my system, so I'm just going to make it cancel. It's going to ask me for Oracle account sign in. So what I'm going to do, even I will not give the password, the download will get started, but better I'm just going to give the password over there. The download is now going to start. Unnecessary, it will get downloaded with my system because it's already there. So I'm just going to make it cancel. So JDK 8, this is the first software I need to install for that. And I think it's already available with your system. So this is the JDK 8. This will get downloaded with my system. JDK, it's already there with my system. Now what we need to do, we just need to click on this. So first of all, we need to install the JDK. I'm just going to click on this. Yes. and it's already installed with my system, so I don't need to do anything. We just need to click on next, 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 finish, it will get installed. This is the first step that we need to do. After the installation, under the program file, we are having the folder called Java. Under the Java, we are having JDK 1.8.0, and we are having the JRE Java Runtime Environment 1.8.0241. This is there. If this option is there, we need to think like, okay, the JDK get installed with my system. So this is the first thing that we need to understand. We can also check the version with our system. I'm just going to open the command prompt. How we can check the version of the Java? I'm just going to write Java hyphen version, and we are getting the version like Java version 1.8.0, which is currently involved with my system. So this is the first thing that you need to do. So our Java get installed. Now, after this, what I need to do, our Java get installed. The next step is we need to install the Python. We need to install the Python. It's Python 2.7. And when I'm going to click on this, it will go with the Python website. In the Python website, right now it's 3.8.2 is available over there. I'm just going for the older one, like the different version is there. We just need to select 2.7. So I'm just going to select the 2.7 over there. Yeah, 2.7 is there. This one is the latest one. No, some other version might be there. 2.7 that I need to select. Yeah, this one is the latest regarding the 2.17. So I'm just going to click on this download. So Python 2.7.16 will get downloaded with my system. I'm just going to click on this. It's already there with my system. So now it is asking for like what source you are looking for. So I'm looking for installer, Windows installer. So after this, if I'm going for this folder, in my download folder it's already there, that's why that option is not coming. In the download folder we are having Python 2.7.17, this option is there, and we just need to click on this, the Python will get installed. It's already there with my system, so I don't need to do anything. You just need to click on the next, 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 finish, it will get installed. After the installation of the Python, how I will check like Python is there or not, I'm just going to in the C drive, and within the C drive we are having the Python 2.7 is there, Python 2.7 is there. And so if this Python 2.7 is there, so now I need to think, okay, Python is ready with my system. Now, one important thing that I need to do, now the Python get installed, number one, Java get installed, number two. Now what I need to do, I need to set the path for the Python. So how we can set the path for the Python, and again what I need to do, so documentation, getting started, prerequisite. The two prerequisites are there. Number one, Java 8. Java 8. So we need to install this. We need to install the Java 8 over here. Okay. So to install, we need to download this. We need to download this. And click on this, it will get installed. We can check the version of the Python, like Java. Like this is how we can check the version. Java hyphen version, we can check the version of the Java. The second thing that we need to install the Python 2.7, that we need to install, and we need to click on this link, install, download, and then we need to click on this. Remember, your Java will get installed with your Java will get installed in the program file. Program file, under the Java folder it will be there, and after the Python it will get installed with C drive with Python. In the C drive there will be the folder for Python 27, so it will be there. So if this particular folder is there, you can understand, okay, Python is installed. So I'm just going in the C drive, like Python 27 is there, so it's fine. Now the next step that we need to do, set the path for the Python. Java path already gets set, but for Python you need to set the path, So how we can do that? I just need to click on this computer, right click, properties, advanced system settings. What we need to do, my computer, right click, properties, advanced system settings. Settings. In the advanced system setting, I just need to click on this. There will be the option called environment variables. We need to click on that. Advanced system settings. In the advanced system settings, there will be the environment called environment variable will be there. Under the environment variable, in the system variable, see, we are having the two variable, one is system and one is user. Under the system variable, we need to select the path. Edit. Now you need to paste. What you need to paste? You need to paste these two options over here. You need to put the path of your Python. My Python was there in the C drive, Python 2.7, and so this is the first thing that you need to set, C:\Python 2.7, and under Python 2.7, and the second thing that we need to set is a script. This one, a script folder is also required, so I'm just going to put semicolon C:\Python 2.7/script. So these two things I need to set over there in the last, in the environment variable. So I'm just going to right click, properties, advanced system settings, environment variable. Under the environment variable we are having the path, click on this edit. After clicking on the edit, see, this is there. In fact, in my system a lot of Python is there. It's a different types of version, different versions is there. You just need to put semicolon, and after that C:\Python 2.7, again semicolon, C:\Python 2.7/script. So you need to set these two paths over here. Remember, semicolon, this is a different path. Path need to be separated with the help of semicolon. So you need to set the path over there. That's it. And okay. So you need to set the path, and then okay. Now you can check it out. I'm just going to open the command prompt. Under the command prompt, I'm going to write the Python. Yeah, if it's going to open, like our Python path is set now. So this is the two things that I need to do. First of all, so I can open the command prompt. In the command prompt, I'm going to write the Python. If something is coming, means everything is fine. So to install the Cassandra, the first thing that we need to install the JDK. At the time of JDK installation, you need to make sure that you are going to install the Java 8. The second thing that you need to click on is Python 2.7. At the time of installation, you need to check whether my system, it will be better like go for the 2.7 because it's, and this one is recommended. Now, the third thing, you need to set the path for the Python. And you can check it out, like how this is how you can set the path. This is basically the environment variable that you need to set. We can also write over here like environment variable. See, if I'm going to put, see, directly we are getting the edit system environment variable. Directly you will be there. You don't need to put right click and all. Directly we are. So otherwise my computer right click property. Otherwise you can write simply environment variable and you will be there in the system variable you can see it. One important thing that you need to do, set Java home. How we can set the Java home? My computer, right click, property, advanced system setting, environment variable. Yeah. Right click, properties, advanced system settings, and now we are having environment variable. In the user variable, we are having the Java home. So under the user variable, I just need to click on new. We just need to click on this new. And I just need to write over java underscore home, that I need to write. Variable name, I'm just going to write Java home, and under the Java home I'm just going to put the values, variable values. So for the values, what I need to do, I need to check the path of like Java. My Java was installed with the program file Java, this JRE. So I just need to select this path of the JRE. So I'm just going to copy this. Yeah, up to this JRE. So I'm just going to copy this. Advanced system settings, environment variable. And I'm just going to put like Java home. It's already there with me. So I'm just going to put Java underscore home. In the Java home, I'm just going to copy this value. So we need to select the path of the JRE, not the JDK. This will be the Java home that I need to set. And okay. Java home is equal to this, and then we just need to press okay. So this is the two things that you need to do first. At first, you need to install the Java, you need to set the Java home. The second, you need to install the Python and you need to set the path for the Python. Now, the fifth step, the next thing that we need to do, fifth option, that we need to start with Cassandra installation. So I'm just going to do that. Google Chrome, Cassandra. .apache.org. Now I'm just going to click on this download Cassandra. So we are in the download center now. You can directly click on this download. Now we need to download the Cassandra. You need to download Cassandra. So this is the URL. Remember, this particular version, something is wrong. Always it creates the problem. The same thing is the problem with the 3.11.5. So better don't install this, otherwise it will create the huge problem. So better go with the 3.11.4. If this one is working with you, with your system, I don't have any problem. But for better understanding, like it's my personal understanding, like 3.11.5 and 0.6, something is problematic over there. It's not going to support Windows properly. So what I'm going to do, I'm just going for the previous version. So I'm just going to click on this older versions of Cassandra are archived here. I'm just going to click on this older supported release. Yeah, I'm just going to click on this archive. Yeah, now we are having the different versions over there. So what I need to do, I'm just going to, like earlier it was 3.11.6. I'm not going to use this, so I'm just going to use 3.11.4. so these are the different versions of Cassandra is there. So I'm just going to use 3.11.4. so this will be the best option for you. Just go with this 3.11.4. so you need to select 3.11.4. you can also select the other version, but it's my personal opinion, there is some problem. It creates a lot of R&D. I did exactly, but I never get any result. So finally I'm working with this 3.11.4. even you can do with that, I don't have any problem. Now what I'm going to do, remember, these are the open source. Open source having a lot of problems. That's the difference between the normal, the product by the individual companies, and individual open sources. In every open sources, lot of problems are there, lot of bugs are there. That basically, that's the reason. Like, it's free of cost, so the problem is there. Like every open source, it's my personal opinion, it's my personal feeling. Like, if I'm going to use the product by any particular company, like suppose some product is from the Microsoft or some product is from the Oracle Corporation, there will be certain standard. Everything with the standard will be there. There will be certain rules and regulation. There will be certain norms. But in case of open sources, always lot of changes, lot of modifications are there. So it's created the problem. So now what I'm going to do, 3.11.11, I'm just going to click on this Apache Cassandra 3.11.4-bin.tar.gz. So I'm just going to download this tar file. Tar file is just like the compressed file. So I'm just going to click on this. So the download will get started. I'm just going to stop this, and my download will be there in the download. Yeah, this tar file will be there, Apache Cassandra. Yeah, this tar file will be there. Sorry. So Apache Cassandra, you just need to click on this Apache Cassandra, bin enter, right click, extract the file, it will get extract. After the extracting, it will create a folder over there. Like we are having the folder called Apache Cassandra, this folder is there. Yeah, the better option will be, so now download this, and after the downloading, right click on this, extract. Now after the extract, right now by default it will be in the download folder. Copy this in C drive, copy this file, the entire folder in C drive. So I just going to copy this entire folder. It's there within the download. So So I'm just going to copy this within a C drive. Yeah, let's get stored over there. So now this is the completion of your installation process. The installation get completed. The installation get completed for me. You need to install the Java, you need to set the path for that. You need to install the Python, you need to set the path for that. For the Java, you need to set the Java home. At the time of download, you need to download this, extract the file, and copy this folder in the C drive. This is the important thing. Now, what I need to do, I need to start the Cassandra. I need to start the Cassandra. So how we can do that? I'm just going in this particular location in the C drive, Apache Cassandra, bean folder is there. I'm just going to click on the bean folder. Under the bean folder, we are having a file called Cassandra.bat. This file I need to execute. This is the server. Like in MongoDB, it was MongoD, that was the server. Here we are having Cassandra.bat, it's a batch file. So I'm just going to open the command prompt, shift right click open command window here. So we are in this Apache Cassandra and all, we are in this location. Now what I'm going to do, so open the command prompt. In this particular command prompt, I just need to write Cassandra. So I'm just going to use Cassandra. It's a batch file, I'm just going to write. So it will start the server. Starting Cassandra server. And a lot of information you will get. You don't need to close this. The entire Cassandra is written in Java. That's why we need JDK. And some interfaces are written in Python. That's why we need the Python. So now our Cassandra gets started. Now what I need to do? So I just need to write Cassandra. Open the another command prompt. Again I'm going to open the another command prompt. In the another command prompt, I'm just going to write, I'm just going to open the another command prompt, cmd. cd. Yeah, now I am in the bean. See, we are having file called SQLSH. This is Cassandra's query cell. This is the environment for the Cassandra. So I'm just going to click on SQLSH, SQL cell, Cassandra query language, like SQL, a structured query language. Here we are having SQL, like Cassandra's query language. SH means cell. So I'm just going to write SQLSH. SQLSH. We just need to click like this. And it will give you the prompt. Yeah. Now it's working. Now we are in the Cassandra environment. So this is the steps that you need to follow. Remember, if you are going to miss any steps, it will create the problem. It will create a lot of problems for the installation and all. So this is the first thing that you need to do. Like this is SQLSH that you need to do. So this is how you need to start with the Cassandra. So everything is there related with the installation. Here you just need to write SQLSH. This is the thing that you need to do. Now, after the installation, so For the installation, what I need to do? These are the prerequisites over there. So how we need to start, go over there, directly go with the documentation, getting started option is there, click on the prerequisite, and you can install the Java from there, you can install the Python. After that, you can set the path for the Python, then you can set the Java home. And remember, at the time of set the Java home, don't make any mistake. You need to select the JRE path, and then you need to download the Cassandra. After downloading the Cassandra, extract the file, copy that particular folder in the C drive, and then start your Cassandra. In one window, write down the Cassandra, it will start the Cassandra server. In another command prompt, write down the SQL SH, it will start the Cassandra query cell. So this is the Cassandra query cell we are having. Here we can write down the Cassandra command and all. So this is how we can start with the Cassandra. So only important thing is, I'm just going to, installation is, it's really, it's a problem. Installation. I'm just going to make the file for this. Installation Cassandra. Now, the few theoretical things that we need to understand regarding the Cassandra is, it's a protected by Apache. It's a NoSQL database. It's a column-oriented database created at Facebook by Avinash Lakshman and Prashant Malik. They were the developer for Facebook inbox search feature. It's an open source. It is highly scalable, high performance, distributed and decentralized database. Right now, Cassandra are used in Facebook, Twitter, Cisco, Ibex, Netflix. All companies are using the Cassandra. It was in open source by Facebook in July 2008. And finally, it was accepted by Apache in March 2009. In the Cassandra, the individual system is known as the node. Like the individual system, it's a place where data gets stored. Data center, it's a collection of multiple nodes. Cluster, collection of multiple data centers. Now, the important thing that you need to remember right now, in Cassandra, we have to use Cassandra query language. Remember one important thing, in Cassandra, the database known as Keyspace. If I need to go for the database is known as Keyspace. This installation is older one, it will not work with your system, so I'm just going to remove this. Now, first of all, like in MongoDB, if I need to create the database, to create the database, what we need to do? We just need to write down the command use over there, use. But in Cassandra, to create the database, what we need to do? To create the database means we need to create the key space over there. To create the key space, what we need to do? We just need to write down the command create keyspace, the name of the keyspace. Now, it's little bit tricky. Here you need to write with replication. Remember, the advantage of Cassandra is, it's always replicate your data. It makes the copy of your data. So in case of any worst scenario, the data lost will be the minimized. Like there will be no any loss of data at all. So at the time of creation of the database, you need to set the replication factor. So I'm just writing create keyspace, the name of the keyspace with replication is equal to. At the time of replication, we need to put the class, like I'm giving class is equal to simple strategy and replication factor 3. Now, there is the two types of strategy there. One is simple strategy. Simple strategy means what? It is used in case of one data center. If we are having one data center, like only one system is there, I will write the class is equal to simple strategy. If we are having the multiple system over there, I will write the class is equal to network topology strategy, more than one data center. Next is the replication factor. Replication factor, it is the number of replica of data placed on different node. So I'm just writing with replication is equal to class is equal to simple strategy, because we are having a single node, and replication factor is equal to 3, so it will create the 3 replica over there. So I'm just writing create key space, the name of the key space, I'm just writing over here create key space Santosh, and now I'm just going to write with replication is equal to class is equal to simple strategy, replication factor I'm just going to give 3. So yeah, so this is how you can create the database. Yeah, database get created. So my database is like Santosh. Now what I need to do, I need to open this database. How we can do that? Use Santosh. Yeah, now we are in the Santosh database. CLS command, here you can also apply. Now under the Santosh database, what I need to do, I want to see the detail about our database. For that purpose, we are having the describe command. Like in Oracle, we are having the describe. The same thing, we are having the describe command over here. We can write describe, and what we can use? We can use key space. Describe key space. See, our key space was Santosh with replication factor was class was simple strategy and replication factor was 3. Now, if I want to make the changes with this, we can make the changes with this. For that, how we can use? We can use alter key space. And in the alter key space, you can make the changes over there. Even you can drop the key spaces, like drop key space, the name of the key spaces. So you can also drop the key spaces. Now, right now, our database is Santosh. Under the Santosh, I want to create a table. Now this table creation is same like Oracle. I'm just going to create a table. Create table EMP. Under the EMP, I'm just going to use the imply number. Now I'm just going to use the INT. Suppose I'm going to use imply name. And in the imply name, I'm just going to use like text over there. See, if I'm going to put semicolon, we are getting the error. Why we are getting the error? Because we don't have any primary key over there. Remember, it's always required the primary key. In the MongoDB, if you are going to create the table, it's always required the primary key. So this is how we can do that. Create table, table name, imply number is a type integer. I'm just going to make it primary key. It's compulsory to define the primary key at the time of entry. And I'm just going to give ename to the type where char output. Oh. Yeah, the table get created. What's the name of the table? It's EMP. Now what I need to do, I need to insert some values. So I'm just going to put that insert into EMP. Here you need to mention the field name over there, imply number comma imply name. Now I'm just going to give the values. What values I need to put? Imply number will be 1 and imply number will be like this. This value get inserted. Once again I'm going to put another values. So this is how you can perform the insert. Now if I need to display the data, select star from EMP. Yeah, these data are there. So this is what exactly the Cassandra is. The important thing is you need to get the key space. Under the key space, you can define the table, just like Oracle. Because it's a columnar database, it's a column oriented database. So it's just like everything will be there with in the table format. Like you are inserting the value, you are applying the select over there. So this